So students, the chapter that we are going to study today is Heron's formula. We have studied different formulas to find area of triangles, parallelograms and other figures. Now we'll try to find a formula that can help us find the area of any triangle, be it an equilateral triangle, an isosceles triangle, a right angle triangle or a scalene triangle. So let's see what is there in the chapter for us. Basically in this chapter we are going to deal with these three things. First we will find the area of triangles using the formulas that we have studied so far. Then we will find the area of those triangles using the Heron's formula that we are going to study in this chapter. Then we will see some application of Heron's formula, how it can be used to find the area of some other figures such as quadrilaterals, parallelograms and rhombus. Let's start with the chapter. First, the basic definition of area. What is an area? Area, as the presentation says, area is the size of the surface. Suppose I draw a diagram. This is a rectangle. This is a rectangular field and a cow or bullock has to plow it. So basically we want to find the area of this rectangle. And when we talk about perimeter, perimeter means the boundary that is across this 2D dimensional shape. So when we want to talk about the fencing or these kind of problems, that we want to build a fence around the field, then we'll talk about problems like perimeter. And when we want to talk about the area that we need to plow in this field, then we'll talk about area problems. Suppose we want to paint this wall, then the problem that I'm talking about is area problem. Now let's start with right angle triangle. Here we have a right angle triangle. Now what is a right angle triangle? As we all know, a right angle triangle is a triangle which has one angle as 90 degree. So here we are given three sides. One side is 12 centimeter, this side is 5 centimeter and this side is 13 centimeter. And this is the right angle. We need to find the area of this triangle. As we all know, to find the area of a triangle, the formula is area is half into base into height. In a right angle triangle, because this length is perpendicular to the base, we consider it as the height. So we know that this 5 is the base for us and this 12 is the height for us, or the perpendicular. So substituting the values, we get the area as half into base is 5 centimeter and height is 12 centimeter. This makes it 30 centimeter square. So we have studied so far that to find an area of a triangle, the formula that we are going to use is half base into height. Now let's look at equilateral triangle. What to do in the case of an equilateral triangle? Now what is an equilateral triangle? Equilateral triangle is a triangle which has all the three sides equal. Now let me draw an equilateral triangle for you. Now this is a triangle which has all the three sides equal. Let's say in this example, all the sides are 10 centimeter. And we wish to find the area of this triangle. So what we are going to do is, we'll drop a perpendicular. Let's say we name this triangle as ABC. We drop a perpendicular from A to BC. Suppose this AD is a perpendicular. So as we all know, the formula for area is half base into height, right? But the problem here is, we know the base. Base is 10 centimeter, but we don't know the height. So let's see whether we can find the height or not. When we drop the perpendicular from point A to BC, the length BC is divided into two equal halves. So these two lengths, say BD and DC, they are divided into two equal halves, so they become 5 centimeter and 5 centimeter. Now as you have dropped the perpendicular, so triangle ABD, it is a right angle triangle, is a right angle triangle. Now in this triangle, using Pythagoras theorem, we have already talked about Pythagoras theorem in the previous class. Triangle, in triangle ABD, AB square is BD square plus AD square. What this Pythagoras theorem says, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. So in this triangle ABD, hypotenuse is AB. So AB square is equal to AD square plus BD square. Now substituting the values to find out our unknown AD. AB square makes it 10 square. Now BD is 5 centimeters, so it becomes 5 square plus AD square, which gives us AD square equals 10 square is 100 minus 5 square, which is 25, so it makes it 75. So AD comes out to be root over 75 centimeter, which is nothing but 5 root 3 centimeter. So we have calculated the value of AD. Now we know the base as it was given to us, and we have found out the value of AD, which is the perpendicular. So easily we can calculate the area of the triangle, which is half base into height. So it becomes half, the base is 10 centimeter and the height, as we found out, is 5 root 3 centimeter. So area becomes 25 root 3 centimeter square. So now in this case, we didn't know the value of the perpendicular, but by using Pythagoras theorem and dropping a perpendicular on the base, we found out the area of the equilateral triangle. Now let's see what happens in the case of an isosceles triangle. Now this is an isosceles triangle. Now what do we mean by an isosceles triangle? A triangle which has two sides equal and the third side unequal is called an isosceles triangle. We have this triangle ABC where the equal sides are 8 cm each. That is AB and AC are 8 cm and BC is 6 cm. And we wish to find the area of this triangle. So as we did in equilateral triangle, we'll do the same thing in isosceles triangle case as well. Area is half into base into height. We know the base, which is 6 cm, which has been given to us, but we need to find the height or the perpendicular. So what we'll do is we'll again drop a perpendicular from A to the base BC. And let's say call it as AD. So AD is a perpendicular, and what we need to do is we need to find the length of AD. So just as we did, we'll consider triangle ABD. Now triangle ABD is a right angle triangle with D as 90 degree, so we can apply Pythagoras theorem in this. So hypotenuse square, which is AB square, is sum of squares of the other two sides, BD square plus AD square. Now AB square is 8 square, which is 64, and BD square. Now when we drop a perpendicular from point A to BC, this BC gets bisected into two equal halves. This BD becomes 3 centimeter and this DC becomes 3 centimeter. So now we know the length of BD and DC. Here we will substitute the value of BD. So it becomes 3 square, that is 9, plus AD square. So AD square becomes 64 minus 9, which is 55, and AD becomes root over 55 centimeter. Now we can easily substitute the value of AD in this formula of area to find the area. We know the base is 6 centimeter and the height is root 55. So the area becomes 3 root over 55 centimeter square. So in the case of equilateral triangle and isosceles triangle, we have calculated the area by calculating the height, which is unknown for us. Now, let's see, if we are given a scalene triangle. Now, what to do in the case of a scalene triangle? Now, what is a scalene triangle? A scalene triangle is a triangle which has all three sides unequal. Now, all the three sides are unequal, let's say this is a triangle A, B, C. Now this side is 40 centimeter. This side, the base is 24 centimeter, and this side is 32 centimeter. And we need to find the area of this triangle. Now the method that we have studied so far won't help us to find the area of this triangle. So let's see what can we do. Now laid back, there was a mathematician, Heron. He gave a formula to find the area of triangles such as scalar triangle. Now what was the formula? The formula says area of a triangle is equal to root over S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. Now what is S? S is semi-perimeter. Now whenever the word semi comes, it means divide by 2. When we say semicircle, it means half of the circle. Now when we say semi-perimeter, it means half of the perimeter. And ABC are the respective sides of the triangle. So when we are given three sides of the triangle, then we can find the area of that triangle by using this formula, which is known as Heron's formula. Now let's see, can we calculate the area for this triangle? The sides are 24 centimeter, 40 centimeter and 32 centimeter. So the perimeter of this triangle would be perimeter of triangle ABC. Now what is perimeter for a triangle? Perimeter is the sum of all these sides. So perimeter would be AB plus BC plus CA. So perimeter becomes AB is 32 centimeter, BC is 24 centimeter and CA is 40 centimeter. So our perimeter becomes 32 plus 40, that is 72, 72 plus 24, it becomes 96 centimeter. But what do we need in this formula? We need to find semi-perimeter. So what we'll do, we'll divide the perimeter by half. So 96 divided by 2 makes it 48 centimeter. So our semi-perimeter is 48 centimeter. Now let us calculate the values of S minus A, S minus B and S minus C respectively. Now S minus A is semi-perimeter, which is 48 minus A. Now let's call this side as A, this side as C and this side as B. So S minus A would be 48 minus 24, which becomes 24 centimeter. And S minus B would be 48 minus 32, which becomes 16 centimeter. And S minus C would be 48 minus 40, which becomes 8 centimeter. So now we have the values of S, S minus A, S minus B and S minus C. So we can easily calculate the area of the triangle by substituting these values into the formula. So let's do it. Area would be S, that is 48, into S minus A, that is 24, into S minus B, that is 16, into S minus C, that is 8. So now we have got a huge multiplication task. So the thing which is advisable is never multiply it at once. Try to find out common multiples so that you can take the common multiples out of the radical sign and you can simplify the expression. Now I can see that I can write 48 as 24 into 2 and I can write 16 as 8 into 2. So what I can do, I can write 48 as 48 becomes 24 into 2, 24 into 2, this 24 remains same, and 16 as 8 into 2. Now, what I'm seeing is that we have 224 under the radical sign. So it becomes 24 into 24, that is 24 square. So I can simply take the 24 out of the radical sign. Similarly, there are two twos inside the radical sign. So it becomes 2 square and we can take the 2 square out of the radical sign and it will become 2. And same goes for 8. So what we have is root over 24 square into 8 square into 2 square. So under the sign we have squares, so now we can solve it, and this becomes 24 into 8 into 2, which is nothing but 24 into 2, 48. We can calculate 48 into 8, which becomes, let's see, 48 into 8, 8 into 64, 8 4 32, 38, 384. So it becomes 384 centimeter square. We have calculated the area of this triangle and it becomes 384 centimeter square. First, what we did was we calculated S, then S minus A, then S minus B and S minus C, and then we calculated the area of the triangle. Now let's see if we can calculate the area of the triangles that we have discussed so far using this formula. The triangles that we discussed was isosceles triangle. So isosceles triangle, this side being 8 cm, this side being 8 cm, and this side being 6 cm. We calculated the area and the area came out to be 3 root 55 cm square. So let's verify whether it is true using Heron's formula. So our perimeter would be, let's say I'll denote perimeter by P. Perimeter would be sum of all the three sides A, B, and C. Let's call this side as, let's say, B, this side as A, and this side as C. So perimeter would be A plus B plus C. That is sum of all the sides. Sum of all the sides will be 8 plus 6 plus 8, which is nothing but 16 plus 6, 22. So semi-perimeter would be half of the perimeter. So it will become 22 by 2, that is 11 centimeter. Now what we need to do is we have to calculate S minus A, S minus B and S minus C. S minus A is, S is 11, so 11 minus A, that is 8. 11 minus 8 is 3 cm. S minus B is 11, 11 minus 8 is again 3 cm. And S minus C, 11 minus 6 is 5 cm. So we have obtained S, S minus A, S minus B and S minus C. Now we can proceed to calculate the area of the triangle. Area of triangle is root over S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. Now we have to substitute the values of S. Let's say S is 11 into S minus A is 3 into S minus B is 3 again, and S minus C is 5. So as I told you before, we will try to take the common terms out of the radical sign. Now we can see that under the radical sign it is becoming 3 square. So we can take the 3 outside and solve the rest. We will get 11 into 5, which is 55. So our area has become 3 root 55 centimeter square, which is exactly the same as we calculated using half base into height. So what we have done is we have calculated the area of an isosceles triangle and an scalene triangle. We can similarly calculate the area of the equilateral triangle that we talked about. So this is a general formula which can help us find the area of any triangle if three sides of the triangle are given, be it scalene triangle, equilateral triangle, right angle triangle or an isosceles triangle. This formula can help us calculate the area of any triangle if all the three sides are given to us. Now, let's try to solve some questions.